If you're using Periscope or Twitter Live, you want to watch this video because today I'm going to show you how you can go live and add your branding to your scopes. Stay right there for another edition of Learn to Livestream with Miss Ileane. I want to introduce you to the Streamlabs mobile app. Now it's available for iOS and Android, and it's going to allow you to do some really cool customization like adding your logo and your call to action. So let's take a look at the interface. I want to walk you through this interface. I've talked about the Streamlabs mobile app before here on my channel. And it's primarily used to go live on Twitch and on YouTube. In fact, they have direct integration with those two platforms. But today, I wanted to just take things a step further and go live on Periscope with the RTMP key. RTMP, I know it sounds super techy, but I don't want you to worry your pretty little head about it. All it is a URL and a line of text characters. That's all it is. So you're going to go over into Periscope Producer and find those two items. They're not hard at all. You'll see it right on the Periscope Producer homepage. You're going to copy them. And what I did was I copied them into a text document. Now I'm on a Mac. I copied them into the Notes app. I'm on a Mac. And so because I copied it into the Notes app, it picked it up on the Notes app on my iPhone. And then I was able to copy and paste those two items into the app. Okay? You with me? Now you might be saying, okay, well, why do you need to go live with an app when you can already go live on the Periscope app? Well, because it gives you additional functionality, like being able to include your branding. See that right there? ILEANESBUDDY.com. I would not be able to display that if I wasn't using this app. Now, I'm actually recording a tutorial on my computer. I'm using the EcammLive record mode, and I'm just going to walk through the interface. All right, the interface of the Streamlabs mobile app. Let's start from left to right. All right, at the far left corner, you'll see the hamburger menu. It's actually a really skinny hamburger menu because this is where you see all the functionality of the app and the different options that you can use. This is where all the secret sauce is hidden for the editor, which I'm going to go into details in a minute. The alert profiles, now those things apply to Twitch mostly and some YouTube. Remote control, that's a way to connect the Streamlabs app that you install on your PC computer. I don't have that one because it's Mac. I'm on a Mac and they don't have a Mac software. And then the settings. The settings are just where you pick your destinations that you want to stream to. That's as simple as that is. So now I'm going to go into the editor. On the editor screen, now you'll notice that there is a rectangular box surrounding my logo. That's known as a widget. Notice I can move that around on screen. So I can put my logo over on the left or move it back over on the right. And at the bottom of the screen on the right-hand side, there is the green icon that lets you go into all your widget options. Okay, so if I was using Twitch, some of these would be more relevant. For example, I could have an alert box and you have the option to show it on stream or on the preview, meaning that only you would see it. Okay, so let's just go down other options that we have here. We can do a chat box, an event list, donation ticker, credits. If you wanted to give credits to maybe your patrons or your subscribers, donation goal, the stream boss, these are things that connect with the app. The viewer count, that works with Twitch and with YouTube, or I could add text. Let's go with normal text. There you go. And now you see subscribe on YouTube. So, really quickly, let's do a quick overview of all of the elements that are on the screen. So you see the hamburger menu, you see this green icon here next to that, that's showing me my signal strength and letting me know that I have good broadcast signal. And then in the middle, over my head, you see that it says custom RTMPs and the URL for the server. Then next would be the share icon. That next little icon that looks like it's got an arrow, it typically denotes sharing. Then there's a icon for microphone. If I needed to mute the microphone, I would use that. Then there, if I wanted to flip the camera around, which of course I'm not going to do. And then there would be an alert icon. That's the last one on the top. Then you see that the stream is in 1080p. And you see the timestamp there of how long I've been streaming. So with that, that's the overview of the Streamlabs mobile app. And I want you guys to check it out. It's absolutely free. And in addition, you can go live on YouTube with this app, even if you don't have the required 1,000 subscribers. That's the beauty of using a third-party app on YouTube. But as you can see with the RTMP key, which is a lot simpler than it sounds, you can also go live on sites like Periscope and add your branding and your call to action. And there you have it. Thank you so much for joining me for another edition of Learn to Livestream with Miss Ileane. Be sure to check out some of the other tutorials we have here. We show you how to go live on YouTube, on Facebook, and Twitch, and so much more. See you in the next video. Bye for now.